Kids started off the day registering and receiving a name tag at the front of the museum from Lee.
Way before electric drills.
Next, Don taught the kids about tools used in colonial times.
So we're going to pass around some hand augments.
Okay. This thing is so overheated. Okay. I want to give it the...
Muddy and rocky things. They break down. So you can see this one there.
Afterwards, kids played games from colonial times.
From the library.
Sharon McDonald and Kathy Cortez then talked to kids about life in colonial times.
But Sharon has a very important Sharon is the historian for the town of Bedford.
Campers then proceeded to hand make a delicious batch of apple cider.
To close out the day, kids learned how to walk on stilts. On Tuesday morning, campers registered and gathered into the barn to discuss the day ahead of them as well as some opportunities at Bedford TV. The kids then went outside and learned some marching skills of militia members in colonial times. Afterwards, Sharon McDonald, Kathy Cortez, and Betsy Anderson taught campers about Bedford's history and government, as well as how they connect to the Mayflower. To wind down, at the end of the day, kids played games from the 1800s.
On Wednesday morning, campers signed in and played outside.
stove here. It's very hot. It's making the water boil. The water's hot. And the wax is in the jars. And that's
Once everyone had arrived, campers made their own candles.
Afterwards, campers had a break and played colonial games.
Kathy Cordes and Sharon McDonald then further prepare kids for their mock town meeting on Friday.
Kids then gathered in groups to discuss articles that were to be brought up on Friday.
Lastly, the campers learned embroidery.
You can make a little pouch to put your marbles in if you would like to. The other thing you can try is some embroidery. So just make an embroidery hoop and just fur that. Let's
To start off their fourth day at camp, kids came in and hung out outside with friends.
For their first activity of the day, campers made lanterns to hold the candles they made on Wednesday. This was done by punching holes in recycled tin cans with a hammer and nail.
Afterwards, kids took a break and played some games.
Suzanne is a funny old man, 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 man. Suzanne is a funny old man.
Kids then got into groups and learned more about Friday's town meeting articles.
Like a swine home, like a dog home. And the swine had to have a worm.
For their last activity of the day, kids made their own butter. On their final day of camp, campers came in, played outside, and watched recaps of past days at camp.
To start off the day, the kids learned how to start a fire with flint and steel.
and you can make sparks by...
The campers then gathered in the barn for a mock town meeting and voted on articles discussed earlier in the week.
To finish off their camp experience, the kids went on a tour of the Joe Blaine house.